more the code. So when you will launch the file, you will see currently I'm connected with a Wi-Fi connection, and till now I have sent a 2 GB of data and I'm receiving data right now. Hey, hello YouTube, I'm Karan from Bharat, and in this video I'm going to talk about one of my old projects that I have created. So recently I've been clearing my old data and deleting all the junk projects that I have created, and I came across one of the good project that I forgot to share with all of you, so I thought I should share it with you now. So the project is based on this command. So while I was learning about batch programming and I was playing with various commands, I came across the netstate minus e command. So what this command does is it tells you through the network interface how much bytes of data you have went through, so how much data you have received and sent over the net. So what I have done is I have used this information and created a simple project. So I'm gonna share that with you in this video. So the project name, I have named it as data analyzer that time. So you can see the demodified date is last 2016, so it is 2 years old project, and it uses Batbox as the helping plugin. So let me first give you a demo before talking about the code. So when you will launch the file, you will see currently I'm connected with a Wi-Fi connection, and till now I have sent a 2 GB of data and I'm receiving data right now. So because of the data overflow, the variables are getting reset itself, so that's why the incoming data is less than the sending data, but in most of the cases the reverse is possible. So here, as we are talking about, so as I'm downloading some videos from YouTube, so that the incoming data is increasing rapidly. So let's talk about some code, and the code is quite simple. You can see it's not that much big, the code is small, it's only of approximate 2 KB. So let me open it in Sublime, and you can see here that I have done nothing special, just enable the delete expansion and set a string variable with default strings like incoming data and sending data. And here I have, at that time of when I was learning, this is the first project where I have set a scale. So I learned about setting up scales using this technique. So I've used for loop and differentiated all the scales and give every scale a value and an ID, unique ID. So here the count variable stands for the unique ID of that unit. So the byte contains unit 1, kilobyte contains unit 2, and so on up to zettabyte. So what I'm doing is I'm getting the information from netstate command and extracting the line containing byte. So let me expand it a little more. So you can see here the netstate minus e command gives you this much output, but when you will combine it with find command, you will see that bytes. Let me write it in double quotes. Okay, the result is case sensitive. So you can see here now this command is not giving a lot of information out, it is just giving a single line of code of information. So we are using that line of information, and using the for loop I'm breaking the line into 3 parts, and the first one is received part and the last one is second send part. So here I'm using that information and saving the information into variables and setting up units. So I'm checking up for the setting up the scale. So how much MBs or GBs of data is getting sent or received? Because if, as you have seen in the raw format, the netstat command is not giving me STAT. It's not giving me the information in kilobytes or megabytes. It is giving the information in bytes. So we have to convert the bytes into the scale we want. So here I've checked for the limit, and here I'm using some string manipulation functions, and after manipulating the last three digits, so I'm getting the floating point values here. So this is the trick you can use for calculating the floating points without using any function, but this may cost you a lot of efforts and a bigger code. So I will highly recommend of using the AC function or the standard functions for calculating floating points, because this technique is universal, but this technique is lengthier. So we should not waste time on things that are already done. So here, after converting the units, I am assigning the name to the units, because we know that which unit is suitable for our received variable, and we know the unit, and we are extracting the values of that unit from the unit ID that we have assigned earlier. So after getting the value or value and the unit, so I am combining all the results here and giving the name of the unit at the last. So you can see this kind of output on the console screen. And the same thing is happening with the sent data, the data that has been sent out, and converting the units, giving them name and assigning values. So after that, here we are comparing some things, and here this is the sub function which is extracting the values. So here I am trying to call the float function, which is not in the code, and I don't think this is being used, so this code we can eliminate that. So here we are using go to next and next, so delete that code may be for the research or testing purpose, but the function should, the program should work fine. As you have seen, the values again reset, and we are again in the megabyte scale. So as we will reach or surpass one value, recommend value of the byte, the netstat command will reset the value to zero. So I'll close that, and let's start the program again and see the output is same or not. So you can see the same output. So the program was last modified in 2016, but we have recently modified it. So in the details, it is now last modified is 2018, but the date created is 2016. So you can see it is a older project. So I think you will like this project, and if you have any doubt or query, please feel free to subscribe and ask it in the comments. And in the end, I'm using Badbox to show all the data at once. So I'm going to wrap it up this video here and ask any question for your doubts. Thanks for watching. Bye bye. Feel free to subscribe. See you. See you in the next video. Bye-bye.